Good afternoon, everybody, and Happy New Year. Welcome to the inauguration of John McCormick as mayor of Woodbridge Township, to the reorganization of the council, including a regular council meeting, an agenda session, and a Board of Health meeting. In a few moments, I'm going to ask you to rise, but before doing so, we're going to stand momentarily for the presentation of the colors led by Captain Paul DeLeo from the Port Reading Fire Department, who is also our township's official bagpiper. He will be escorting members of the American Legion T-Nulty Post 471 in Island as they present the colors. They'll be joined under leadership by Police Officer Eric Ransom with the North Jersey Young Marines. I will then ask for everyone to remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by retired Navy John Eberhardt from the Veterans Alliance, followed by the National Anthem under the leadership of Lisa Romero, the choral director here at Woodbridge High School for the award-winning choir. And then we will have the dismissal of the color guard. And again, the invocation will be by Father Smith from St. Anthony of Padua in Port Reading. So at this time, I would ask you to please rise. And if we can please have the presentation of the colors. After the Pledge of Allegiance, I also ask in your thoughts and your prayers that you keep in your memories the family of Lowell Obey, who is the commander of our community emergency response team, who passed away unexpectedly this week. Mr. Eberhardt.
Present colors. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Rifle bearers, right shoulder, arm. Corner guard, right, face. Prepare to march. On my mark, left turn.
Forward. Come on.
Again, continue to remain standing for the invocation by Father Smith. Father?
Let us pray. God of power and might, wisdom and justice, through you authority is rightly administered, laws enacted, and judgment is decreed. Assist with your spiritual counsel, Mayor John McCormick. May his administration be conducted for the common good of all the people of the Township of Woodbridge. Let your light of your divine wisdom direct the deliberations of the Woodbridge Township Council. May that line shine forth in all their proceedings and the laws they enact. We pray to you who is God forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated. Notice requirements of the open public meeting law have been satisfied concerning this meeting. The Home News Tribune and the Star Ledger published a notice that was posted on the municipal bulletin board and should be so noted in the minutes of this meeting. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the Honorable Congressman Frank Pallone to swear in John McCormick as mayor. Congressman?
Thank you. I'm going to swear in the mayor, but I just have to say something about him and your town very briefly, if I could. First of all, I want to say how proud I am to represent Woodbridge, and I always use that as an example. In fact, some of the other mayors get tired of me going around saying, well, you know, this is what they do in Woodbridge. Why aren't you doing that here? They say, will you stop? But part of the reason why I say that is because I see so many innovative things happen. There's continued progress in the town, but there's so much innovation, you know, new recreational opportunities, new business opportunities. I was thinking of the Avenel Performing Arts Center as just as an example of that. But I think also your mayor and council always look out for the average citizen. They worry about the tax dollars. They want to make sure your tax dollars are spent wisely. And the mayor and the council work together so well. It's almost like a family. So I think maybe sometimes you take for granted some of these things, but Woodbridge is really special, and I just want you to know that today before we have the ceremony of swearing in your mayor once again. So what are we going to do now? Okay. Do you, John E. McCormick, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and that you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all laws and perform all the duties of the office of mayor according to the best of your ability, so help you God?
Yes, I do.
Congratulations.
At this time, I give you Mayor John McCormick.
Thank you. Thank you to Father Bill Smith, who's been a good friend since 1990, for doing the invocation. And thank you to Father John Gloss of my home parish of St. John Vianney for offering the benediction. The two of you are amazing in your commitment not only to your own parishes, but to the entire community of Woodbridge as a whole. Thank you to Congressman Pallone for performing the swearing-in ceremony. You're the fourth most powerful congressman in the country, and you've been a great friend to Woodbridge since we were put into your congressional district. Despite all the craziness you deal with in Washington, D.C., you always find time to come to Woodbridge to be with us at our many township events. Along with Senators Booker and Menendez, you form a formidable trio of terrific public servants who are only a phone call away from us. Thank you, Congressman. Thank you to the National Award-winning Woodbridge High School Choir and first-year director Lisa Romero. Lisa, nobody would ever know you've been on this job for less than 4 months. The students have given up much of their time the last few weeks to learn and practice these songs, and we thank them, and you can keep the t-shirts. Thank you to our state legislators, Senator Joe Vitale, Assemblyman Craig Coughlin, and Assemblywoman Yvonne Lopez, especially when it comes to securing state grants, which in the last 2 years have produced funding for the level playing field at the Cypress Rec Center, for the renovation of the Mount Carmel facility into township community uses, and the biggest one of all, for the reconstruction of the intersection of Route 9 and Main Street. Special congratulations to Craig Coughlin, who was just reelected by his peers as the Speaker of the New Jersey General Assembly for another 2-year term. Thank you to our Middlesex County Freeholders, especially our very own Charlie Kenny from Woodbridge, and Freeholder Director Ron Rios and Deputy Director Charlie Tamaro, along with Sheriff Millie Scott. Without the county, we would have over 100 less acres of open space, and we would not have our crown jewel, the Avenel Performing Arts Center. Our at-large Township Council team of Lizbeth DeJesus, Brian Small, Kyle Anderson, Greg Ficarra, and I just spent several months together campaigning for re-election. We were successful, and we are looking forward to 4 more years of progress in moving the Township of Woodbridge forward. Congratulations in advance to Liz Beth, who will hopefully be elected as our council president in a few minutes. Thank you to the four of you, and congratulations on your victories. We get to do it all over again in 2021 when our ward council team is up for re-election. We will work just as hard for them as we did for ourselves, and just like they worked for us. Nancy Drummond the first, Howie Bauer in the second, Corey Spiller in the third, Viru Patel in the fourth, and Debbie Mead in the fifth round out our terrific council team. Thank you all. Years ago, a reporter asked a group of different elected officials to give him the most important word we could think of in our jobs. I said relationships. Without them, we fail, and with them, we succeed. I mentioned 24 names at all different levels of government so far today, and each and every one of them have a terrific relationship with each other. We get along, we support each other, we socialize with each other, we know each other's families. When you have a good relationship with someone, you can work through problems and issues and come to conclusions for the betterment of our common constituents. We do not always agree, but our respect for each other is very strong. We stay together. Woodbridge Township is stronger because of the relationships all of our elected officials have with each other, and once again, I thank each and every one of you. A few weeks ago, I spoke to a government class at JFK High School, and one of the students asked about the importance of a cabinet to a chief executive. I said there's nothing more important to the success of not only an individual, but also of an organization than the leaders that are chosen to lead it. Governments need experienced managers to run the day-to-day business of a municipality. We need people not only who know what they're doing, but who have the ability to communicate with their workers and gain their respect. We need people who understand that their ultimate boss is the citizen they are dealing with at any given time. I would like to thank our former business administrator, John Bennett, for his 2 years of service to Woodbridge. I would now like to introduce, for the first time in public, our new business administrator, Vito Simaluca, assuming that the Township Council approves the resolution appointing him in a few minutes. Vito started working for the Township 37 years ago as a laborer who worked his way up to senior mechanic while also working part-time on the police reserves. It is a true success story that he is now the chief operating officer of a $200 million a year business. 10 years ago, I asked Vito to take over the operation of our ice rink at the Woodbridge Community Center, knowing that he knew all about rinks because his son was and remains a national caliber hockey player. After seeing Vito for less than a year in that job, we put him in charge of the entire center, and not long after that, in charge of our entire recreation department. Those responsibilities grew to include the club at Woodbridge after we purchased it, and the Avenel Performing Arts Center after we built it. After one Sunday afternoon meeting around Vito's Kitchen Island talking about these projects with Chief of Staff Carolyn Ehrlich, I said to Carol, I know who our next BA is, and she agreed. The opportunity came up, and I'm thrilled to have Vito in his new position, and even more thrilled to have him as one of my best friends. Thank you, Vito. Carol is not only the Chief of Staff, but also the Redevelopment Agency Director, where she oversees dozens of projects in Woodbridge. Her work has resulted in nearly $20 million in additional tax revenue in this year's budget, and that number will grow to $30 million annually in a few years. Her work has cleaned up a dozen contaminated sites in town and led to the creation of thousands of new jobs. Carolyn has been my best friend since the mid-1990s when I was the Township Chief Financial Officer and she was a councilwoman. I love this job more than you can imagine, but it would not be nearly as enjoyable without Carol, who is literally by my side every day, advising me and participating in the decision-making and coming up with ideas to make Woodbridge a better place. We've been a team for 23 years, and we're not stopping anytime soon. Thank you, Carolyn. Special thanks to Casey Wagner as Deputy Business Administrator and Heather LaMotta as Deputy Director of Redevelopment, who represent an incredibly strong team of young managers who will be running this town someday. Casey and Heather, thank you. John Mitch is a lifelong Woodbridge resident who knows more people than I do, and he is experienced and wise and thoughtful and is widely respected and known as the top municipal clerk in the state of New Jersey. Thank you, John. John Haggerty makes sure that people know about the great things that happen in Woodbridge Township every single day, but he has also expanded into much more than newsletters and websites by providing insight into all aspects of government. Thank you, John Haggerty. The department that the public sees most in any local government is Public Works. And I can confidently say without reservation that there is no better group of DPW employees in the state than right here in Woodbridge Township. Most mayors fear snow, but here in Woodbridge, we know that our roads will be cleared before and better than any town around us. Our sanitation and recycling programs are outstanding and working so well that people forget the days of buying their own garbage cans and separating paper and cans and glass. We have paved more roads in the last 10 years than most towns do in 20 years. Our crews work on construction and demolition and everything in between, and we keep challenging them with more and more tasks. They also talk to our residents regularly while on the job, and I honestly get 10 compliments for every complaint. George Brew has taken the helm of the Department of Public Works after many years serving as a deputy, and he was welcomed with snow and rain and our holiday parade on his first day on the job, December 1st. Thank you, George, and your DPW crews. For just short of 45 years, Dennis Henry worked in the Department of Public Works, starting as a mechanic and working his way up to director for the past 14 years. Dennis just retired, and I have personally praised Dennis many, many times since becoming mayor, and I know our council has also recognized Dennis. So for one more time, let us recognize an outstanding leader and thank Dennis Henry for his amazing tenure working for the Township of Woodbridge. Dennis, if you're out there, please stand. The next most obvious department to our citizens is the police department, although most residents hope they never have to interact with them directly. We also believe that our department is the best in the state, but in this case, we can prove it. Every 3 years, a national group of experts from around the country comes in and reviews every policy, practice, and procedure of our department in an exhaustive analysis. Each and every time, the Woodbridge PD comes out with flying colors. The reviewers meet with us in an exit conference and personally tell us how great our team is. The fact is that most departments don't even try for certification, and many try and fail. There are only a handful of departments in the state that are certified, and we are proud that we are one of them. Police Director Bob Hubner, Deputy Director Joe Niski, and Chief Law Enforcement Officer Scott Kuzma run the police department as lifelong officers and with professionalism and a commitment to law enforcement that is simply unmatched anywhere. Thank you, Bob, Joe, and Scott. Twenty-five years ago, our recreation department ran two parades, some summer and sports camps, and some adult sports leagues with a handful of employees. Now they run the Woodbridge Community Center with all of its amenities and 200 employees. They run the club at Woodbridge and its 200 employees with an array of offerings that just keeps growing. There are more parades and more camps with more playgrounds and more kids involved than ever before. They have expanded arts opportunities in Woodbridge and run more recreational buildings and fields than we ever imagined, including our second teen center set to open later this year. Vito leaves the department in good hands with Deputy Director Brian Molnar taking over and with Community Center Coordinator Paul Losick moving up to deputy. They and their team have made Woodbridge a terrific town to grow up in. Thank you, Brian and Paul and the Recreation Department. Twenty-five years ago, the health department ran one senior center. We had no privately run senior housing complexes, an awful animal shelter, minimal health screenings, mediocre senior transportation services from an outside entity, and limited outreach to our homebound senior population. The township just opened its fourth senior center, and now there is brand new privately owned senior housing at the Reinhard, Delina, and Red Oak complexes with more to follow, plus 200 stunning new apartments called Jacob's Landing to replace the decrepit 150 units on Buns Lane. Our animal shelter is state-of-the-art, and we have an amazing array of programs and services to all seniors in Woodbridge, whether they are active at events or inactive at home. Our initiation of our very own senior busing has been simply amazing. Thanks to Director Dennis Green, Michelle Morgan, Phil Bajowski, and Shirley Genty and their staffs for making Woodbridge a terrific town to grow old in. Special thanks go to Dr. Bonnie Nolan, who has established Woodbridge as the best town in New Jersey for dealing with people addicted to drugs and people in recovery. Her programs and services and staff are so good that seven other towns contracted with Woodbridge to provide services to them. Thank you, Dr. Bonnie Nolan. 25 years ago, the township was relatively stagnant in regard to economic development, brownfield cleanup, and job creation. Now Woodbridge is a statewide model in how to grow a town economy while also providing a good quality of life for our residents. The planning department, under the direction of Marta Levski-Darden, with Building Division Head Tom Kelly and Zoning Officer Tony Tortorello, keep setting new records for construction activity. They make it so easy for companies to get through the process from plan review to board approvals to building permits and inspections and finally a certificate of occupancy. Their focus is to make Woodbridge Township a terrific town for people to work in. Thank you, Marta, and the Planning Department. Although the Engineering Division is technically a part of Public Works, it really stands alone due to the amount of work that flows through there. Mike Gellin has been here for several years, and he and his employees are outstanding. They are knowledgeable and efficient, and they always take the time to explain to residents all about the work they do. Thank you, Mike. Chris Costi is our special projects manager, and we certainly have a lot of those to keep him busy. Chris brings a level of experience and wisdom to his work that is truly appreciated. Thank you, Chris. There are many unnoticed but very important divisions within our government, which, although it's not as obvious as the ones we mentioned, mean just as much to our overall success as a municipality. The Woodbridge Public Library with Monica Eppinger, the Municipal Court with Phil DiNicola, the Clerk's Office with John Mitch, the Tax Collector's Office with Rich Lorenzen, and the Tax Assessors with Rich Duda, the Controller's Office with Manny Fernandez and Mike Klepchik, along with Purchasing and Personnel with Marian Horta, and Information Technology with Brian Austin. Thank you to all of you and your hardworking staffs. I'd like to offer a special thanks to the Law Department with Jim Nolan, Eric Lang, and Erica Aber. And of course, the wonderful employees in the Mayor's Office, Cindy, Loretta, and Jerry, along with Megan Kushba, who works with John Haggerty. They all handle so much directly, which takes a big burden off of our senior management team. Thank you to everyone who works hard every day for our residents. In Woodbridge, we also have a Board of Education and administrative staff that is committed and dedicated to bringing the very best to our school district. We cooperate in ways unheard of anywhere else in the state of New Jersey. Dr. Robert Zaga is the leader of the district as superintendent, and his administration team of John Bader, Dr. Joe Massimino, Julie Baer, and Brian Wolferman interact with us on a daily basis. Board members Jonathan Treewasser, Joe Velez, A.J. Sedana, Dan Harris, Brian Molnar, and Marie Anderson are also with us today. It is really very simple. Administrators of a town and of a school district should work together because we share the exact same constituents. And the better the schools are, the better a town is. If you work for our Board of Education, thank you for your service. A person does not have to work for the township or school system, though, to make an impact on our quality of life. We have hundreds of citizens on boards and commissions and committees, including many who will be appointed or reappointed today. We have really tough assignments like the zoning or planning boards and other committees that appeal to people interested in the environment, history, wellness, housing, the arts, and many other areas. If you want to taste a little of everything in Woodbridge, the Mayor's Advisory Committee under the leadership of Terry Sharkey gives you that chance. If you serve on a board or commission, thank you. A few weeks ago, we honored all of the people involved in dealing with the plane crash in Colonia. All nine of our fire districts responded along with four of our first aid squads. Our police and 911 dispatchers, our community emergency response team, which will never be the same without Law Lobby, and our Office of Emergency Management under the direction of Patrick Kenny, all worked incredibly hard to keep the damage to just three homes in that unprecedented catastrophe, which would have been so much worse without the quick action of our emergency service workers. We are used to that type of professionalism here in Woodbridge, but now the whole country literally saw how our crews responded so well. If you are a first responder or in the field of emergency management, thank you. That incident really reminded us about the people of Woodbridge and their willingness to reach out to the three families impacted by the plane crash. Over $50,000 was collected in checks and gift cards in just 3 weeks, which shows how our community really comes together in time of need. Our dozen veterans organizations, under the leadership of John Eberhardt as head of the Veterans Alliance, do so much for our community. Perhaps their best work is in helping our youth through the junior ROTC and the young Marines, and by virtue of their many visits to our school for Veterans Day. Special thanks to our favorite veteran, 97-year-old Stu Brandow, who snuck out of his physical rehab facility in South Amboy to be with us here today. Stewie. We have over 50 houses of worship who run soup kitchens and food pantries and who help people with employment, housing, family matters, and numerous other issues. If you are connected to one of our veterans, religious, or community organizations, thank you. I would like to make a quick pitch for the commercial aspects of our municipal operation. We built the Woodbridge Community Center and it opened in 2002 and stands as a great place for wellness and recreation. We bought the club at Woodbridge 15 months ago, and we're giving that place a major facelift with new locker rooms and amenities like the golf den, where you can play any course of the world in the world or just practice your swing. Since we bought the club, our membership there and at the community center have both increased by more than 400 members. Our Avenel Performing Arts Center is only in its ninth month of operation, but we are really hitting our stride, and we have a terrific schedule of shows for 2020, thanks to the hard work of our own Emmy Award-winning Executive Director, Anthony Wilkinson. Thank you, Anthony. Curtin's Restaurant has been steadily increasing in business, and we like nothing better than a waiting line for tables. Most towns do not venture into commercial businesses, but we have, and we intend to continue doing more. We will only be more successful with your patronage and support. Lastly, I would like to thank my family for their support for the last 13 years. Being an elected official means hours away from home, and it means missed meals and missed trips, and means phones ringing and beeping at all hours of the day and night. None of us up here can do the job we do without the support of our family, and I would like to thank my wife, Tammy, and my daughter, Erin, for their constant support. I'm also happy to have my mother, Mary, here with my sisters, Anne Marie, and her husband, John, sister, Maureen, and brother, Tommy, along with Erin's boyfriend, Chris, and his mother, Pat. It's great to celebrate with all of you, and I'm glad you're all here. Being the best town around means you have the best employees around, the best volunteers around, and the best people around. Five of us got elected 2 months ago, but each vote for us was also a vote for everyone on our incredible township team. They just can't fit 1,200 names on the voting screen. Thank you for the opportunity to lead the great township of Woodbridge and keep it moving forward for another year, for another term, and into the next decade. Woodbridge truly is the best town around. Thank you.
It's hot up here, man.
I know, you're sweating. Take all that.
All right.
Thank you. You're good. Thank you.
Thanks. Now I'd like to introduce the dais behind us here, starting in the back, your back right. You can sit down. I can see you better. Barron Arts Center Coordinator Cynthia Knight, Special Projects Coordinator Chris Costi, Recreation Director Brian Molnar, Tax Assessor Rich Duda, Deputy Police Director Joe Niski, Tax Collector Rich Lorenzen, Emergency Management Coordinator Patrick Kenny, TV 35 Director Lee Beckerman, Township Engineer Mike Gellin, Deputy Director of Redevelopment Heather LaMotta, Deputy Business Administrator, having a problem with that word today, Administrator Casey Wagner, Library Director Monica Eppinger, Court Director Phil DiNicola, Health Director Dennis Green, Planning Director Marta Lefsky, Public Works Director George Brew, Police Director Bob Hubner, Business Administrator Vito Simaluca, Communications Director John Haggerty, Chief of Staff Carolyn Ehrlich, you already met the councilman, Congressman, Father John Gloss of St. John Vianney, and you already met Father Bill Smith of St. Anthony. Thank you all for being here.
This time I'd like to invite back the award-winning choir under the direction of Lisa Romero. Thank you. This time it's my pleasure to swear in the four at-large council members. At this time, starting alphabetically with Kyle Anderson. If Kyle's family could please come forward. Do you, Kyle Anderson, solemnly swear that you'll support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilman at Large according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Congratulations, Councilman Anderson. Lizbeth De Jesus, if her family could come forward, please. Do you, Lizbeth De Jesus, solemnly swear that you'll support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilwoman at Large according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Congratulations. Greg Ficarra, if his family come forward, please. Greg Ficarra, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people. You will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilman at Large according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Congratulations, sir. Brian Small. His family, please. Do you, Brian Small, solemnly swear that you'll support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you'll bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Councilman at Large according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I will.
Congratulations. At this time, I'd like to call for a nomination for the office of Council President for 2020. Do I have any nominations?
I'd like to make a
Councilwoman Drum.
I'd like to make a nomination for my Councilwoman at Large, Lizbeth de Jesus, for the 2020 Council President seat. And as she is well aware, that seat comes with a gavel. During Lizbeth's tenure on the Council and serving as the past Council Vice President under Councilman Spiller, she has demonstrated much growth and commitment to our Woodbridge community at large. She is an advocate for a plethora of township outreach, including, but not limited to, our Hispanic community, our library system, and girls' sports, making her deserving of this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Do I have a second on the nomination?
I would like to second that nomination. I would like to nominate Councilwoman Lizbeth de Jesus to be the next council president. Lizbeth is an amazing councilwoman, a strong leader, and a true advocate for the residents of Woodbridge Township, especially the girls. I have no doubt she will lead our team in 2020 with strength, passion, grace, and fairness to every resident who reaches out for her help. Congratulations, Liz.
Thank you. Are there any other nominations for Council President? Any other nominations for Council President?
No.
Council President, please step forward. And if I can have the De Jesus family back up. Do you, Lizbeth de Jesus, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, and that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the office of Council President according to the best of your ability, so help you God.
I do.
Congratulations. I present to you our Council President, Lizbeth de Jesus.
Thank you so much. First, I would like to thank all of our residents that came out on Election Day and re-elected me for another term. As your public servant, I want you to know that I will continue to work hard for all in Woodbridge Township. Along with my fellow council members, we will continue to work with the mayor and administration to ensure that Woodbridge continues to be a vibrant, diverse, and forward-moving community. If you would allow me at this time, I would like to acknowledge our Spanish-speaking residents. Les doy las gracias por haberme dado la oportunidad de servirles por otros cuatro años como su concejal. Espero trabajar juntos para la mejoría y el progreso de nuestra comunidad. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our Woodbridge Democratic Chairwoman Tish Coughlin and her team for their dedication and hard work to ensure that we had a successful election. I know it looks like a book, but I promise I'll be quick. At this time, I would like to thank my team, my family, my husband Angel, my children, Angel Christian, Matthew, Brianna, and Madison. As public officials, we heavily depend on our families to be our continuous support and strength while advocating and working for our residents. And my children especially love Angel's dedication to buying local at dinner time. To my councilmates, thank you for this honor and entrusting me to lead with you as we continue to work for our residents. To our outgoing President Corey Spiller, thank you for your dedication and for your example. As Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg stated, and I quote, "Women belong in all places where decisions are being made," end quote. I stand here along with Nancy Drum, Debbie Meehan, former Councilwomen Brenda Velasco, Sandy Benny, and Chief of Staff Carolyn Elrick, as role models for future generations of young girls. As a mother of two young ladies, Brianna and Madison, It is vitally important for them to know that the seat I hold is not about me, but about them and future girls like them. That not only women, but women of color can also have a seat at the table. Like no other community, the level of priority that we give our future, the children of our township, is demonstrated as we work closely with the mayor, the administration, and the Board of Education. The level of priority that we give our seniors is evident as we meet their needs, for example, housing and senior transportation. We pay close attention and work towards achieving milestones with the families of children and adults with special needs. These are a few highlights of what Woodbridge Township is so special. I would like to take the opportunity to congratulate our mayor on his reelection, and I would also like to thank our directors and their respective departments for continuing their exceptional work. I look forward to working with you all. I would like to thank Woodbridge High School not only for their hospitality, but also for the beautiful music provided by the Woodbridge High School Choir and their director, Lisa Romero. To our municipal clerk, John Mitch, our director, Haggerty, and everyone that helped put this event together, thank you. And last but not least, a special thank you and prayer goes out to all of our first responders. May God bless you and keep you safe. May God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
At this time, I seek nominations for the office of Council Vice President.
Mr. Mitch.
Councilman Spiller.
Thank you. I've known Councilman Small for over 25 years. Brian, father to Amanda, Brian, Kyle, and Brielle, and now grandpa to Jordan Claire. Brian has always put his family first. 25-year retired veteran of our fine Woodbridge Police Department. Brian's also a three-time ex-chief of the Port Reading Fire Department, past captain and current president of the First Aid Squad, as well as fire official. Brian has served at all levels in our township youth recreation leagues, including president of the Woodbridge Little League and forming the Woodbridge PBA Street Hockey League. Brian brought seasoned experience to our council as he served as Board of Education member for numerous years, including holding the position of president. Because of this, it is my great honor to nominate my good friend, Councilman Brian Small, as Council Vice President.
Thank you, Councilman. Do we have a second?
Yes, Mr. Mitch.
Councilman Bauer.
Mr. Mitch, I second the nomination for Councilman Brian Small for Council Vice President. I have known Brian Small personally for over 30 years. And Brian is a man with strong family values, is not only dedicated to his family, but to all residents of Woodbridge Township. Brian has spent the majority of adult life giving back to his community through the many organizations he has been part of professionally and as a volunteer. His actions as a leader inspires others to do more, learn more, and motivate people to achieve a common goal for the better of our community. It's an honor and a privilege to second the nomination of Brian Small for the position of Council Vice President. Congratulations, Brian.
Thank you, Mr. Bauer. Any other nominations for Council Vice President? Any other nominations for Council Vice President? Mr. Small, please step forward, and your family, please come back up. Do you, Brian Small, solemnly swear that you will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, that you will bear faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States and in this state under the authority of the people, and you will faithfully, impartially, and justly enforce all the laws and perform all the duties of the Office of Council Vice President according to the best of your ability, so help you God?
I do.
Congratulations, sir. Vice President Small.
Good afternoon.
I want to welcome all our family, friends, and guests here today. I am humbled and honored to be chosen to serve as a Township Vice President. I want to thank my colleagues. The progress we've made would not be possible without the commitment of every one of you, including that of the leadership of our Council President from 2019, Corey Spiller. I look forward to supporting your goals and continue to highlight the important work of this body does every day alongside our current Council President, Lizbeth DeJesus. I want to thank our Municipal Clerk, John Mitch, and his staff. You make us all look good. I feel blessed to work with you in a partnership. Thank you for choosing to serve and lending your expertise and talent to this great township. I want to congratulate our Mayor, John McCormick, on his fourth term. I look forward to working in a partnership with you and your administration to continue and implement impactful policies that will lift up every resident and community as a whole. Our residents have placed their trust and hopes in us to do this work and to do it well, with integrity and courage. Thank you, residents, for believing in us, for your encouragement, and for your community leadership and your ideas. Last but certainly not least, I want to thank my children, Amanda, her husband Joe, Brian Jr., Kyle, Brielle, and my new granddaughter, Jordan. Your love and support is immeasurable. Thank you. God bless you all. God bless America.
This time I bring the choir back up, please.
I feel alive.
At this time, we're going to move into the meeting portion of our meeting. Bear with us, it will only take a few minutes, but at this time, I'd also like opportunity to offer anybody from the public and a comment to speak. Hearing no comment, can I get a motion by the council to close that portion of the meeting?
Motion.
Second. Got a motion and properly second. Any comments or questions? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Can I get a motion to approve the minutes from our last meeting of December 17th, 2019?
Motion.
Second.
Got a motion and properly second. Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Beginning with the agenda listed on your alphanumeric agenda this afternoon, I'm going to take resolutions 1, 2, and 3, beginning with resolutions 1 and 2 first, which is a confirmation of the appointment of our council president and council vice president. Can I get a motion by consent to approve 1 and 2?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. We also have the third resolution, which is the appointment of our new business administrator, Vito Simaluca. Can I get a motion to approve that?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Again, Mr. Simaluca. You also have a number of first reading ordinances there listed in front of you, alphanumeric from A to J. If I could get a motion to approve these all on first reading, published in the Home News Tribune on January 7, 2020, with notice of public hearing to be held on January 21, 2020 at 7 p.m.
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. You also have a number of resolutions that follow, beginning with number 4 and going up to 87. Can I get a motion by consent to approve 4 through 87?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments from council? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. At this time, I want to thank Mr. Lottman, who was in the audience too, the principal for Woodbridge High School, for allowing us to use your facility today. I'd like to turn this portion of the meeting over to our council president for the agenda session. Council President De Jesus.
Thank you. At this time, I would like to ask council to hold their agendas, and I would like to open it up to any comments from our council, starting with our dean of council, Councilman Picara.
Thank you. Happy New Year to everybody. Thanks for coming out. Special thanks to my family for their love and support. And we look forward to continuing to serve you and the rest of our community for the next 4 years. God bless everyone.
Councilman Anderson.
I would like to thank everyone for coming out today, especially my family in the second row there, the entire second row. And if I could leave you with a quote. As we express our gratitude, it is important for us to remember that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. Thank you.
Councilwoman Drum.
Thank you. I wanted to wish everyone a happy, safe, and healthy 2020, and my best to our new council president, Lizbeth De Jesus, and to my right, our new vice president, Councilman Small. Thank you very much.
Councilman Bauer.
Thank you, Council President. I'd like to congratulate all our appointments today. Congratulate you on your success as being Council President, and Brian on your position as Council Vice President. President, I'd like to wish everybody a happy and safe New Year. Thank you.
Councilman Spiller.
Having some technical difficulties down here. Thank you, Council President. I'd just like to congratulate the mayor and my fellow council at large. Congratulate Council President De Jesus, Council Vice President Small. It'll be a pleasure to work with you. Happy New Year.
Thank you, Council President. I would just like to congratulate Lizbeth and Brian. I know they will do an excellent job, and I'd also like to congratulate our new BA, Vito Simaluca. I know he will do a great job also. And just wishing everybody a happy and healthy New Year.
Councilman Patel.
Yeah, I think that's fine.
Yes, I would like to also congratulate the newly appointed president and vice president. Also, I would like to congratulate our mayor, all the new, re-elected our council members at large, and all the directors, you know, best of luck and best wishes, and also to every one of you, wishing you a happy and healthy new year ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Council President, if I can get a motion also to suspend the agenda for the Board of Health meeting.
Motion. Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Any other comment, Council President?
At this time, I would like to ask anyone that was appointed to our board or commission members to please stand. Anyone that is currently serving on any of our board or commission, please stand.
Let's give them a round of applause. As we begin to close out our program for today, I'm going to ask the choir to please come back up. They're going to play a selection. We will then do the benediction, and they will close out with God Bless America. And while they're setting up, Council President, I believe you wanted to extend an invitation.
Yes, I would like to invite everyone here to across the hall to the gym for a light reception. We can meet you there and talk. Thank you.
Eating. And talking. Eating.
Again, if the choir can remain in place, I give you Father Gloss from St. John Vianney. Father.
Almighty and eternal God, you are known by many names as you have revealed your glory to all the nations. God of power and might, wisdom and justice, through you authority is rightly administered, laws are enacted, and judgment is decreed. Blessed with your spirit of counsel and fortitude, Mayor John McCormick of Woodbridge Township, that his administration may be conducted in righteousness and be useful for the people of Woodbridge. Bless him as he encourages respect for law. May he guard the welfare of all the citizens of Woodbridge. Bless him with your powerful protection, that he might discharge his duties with honesty and ability. Bless with the light of your divine wisdom the town council, that it might shine forth in all its proceedings as they frame laws to govern this township. Bless them as they seek to preserve peace, promote happiness, and continue to bring the blessings of liberty and equality to all the residents of Woodbridge Township. Bless all the citizens of Woodbridge with the knowledge so they may respect and observe your law and the laws of our township. Bless them with peace and prosperity under this administration. Finally, bless all of us gathered here today with the ancient blessing of Aaron. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with kindness and give you peace. We pray this, O Lord our God, and ask that this prayer come to you as on the wings of an eagle. Amen.
Adjourn.
Motion.
Second.
Meeting adjourned.
Thank you and Happy New Year, everybody.